orders. He's in it for personal reasons. I thought it was better not to do a caricaturization of Wooters because so many of the situations that you see him in the film are not real situations that he was in. But I tried to find a way to honor the memory of him. It's just so interesting what you learn from the research. It helps to inform the world for you. Yet there's a lot of creative license that's been taken with the film.
Ryan Gosling pulled me aside immediately, and he really wanted to know about my dad. You know, he was grilling me. He wanted to know what my dad was like, what his personality like. So that was good, you know. So I tried to tell him the best I could. He was really streetwise. He had connections everywhere. I think a big part of that was his friendship with Jack Whalen. He knew of Mickey Cohen because he was busting bookie joints that Mickey Cohen was running. I know my dad was intent on getting him in jail.
What's interesting about Wooters is the character is not as virtuous as the other members of the squad. They're sort of there because they feel compelled to right all the wrongs. And Wooters, he's not trying to be a hero. He served his time overseas. He comes home and there's another war on, but I don't think he particularly feels like that's his war to fight. I think Wooters has a lot of respect for Amara. They were both in the war together, but I think they just have wildly different ideas of what it means to be effective. In the film, we made it so that he was in the Air Force, and so he was a part of it, but he was dropping bombs from above, and he never had to deal with the actual carnage. And so he's kind of applying the same strategy to this. Just sort of trying to hide out in some bar somewhere, you know? Until it's all over.
I wish I could help, but I'm just in the middle of a very important case, so.
Wooters, he has a friendship with this little shoeshine kid named Pete, but because of his complacency, Pete dies. He feels responsible for that. So now he's got personal reasons for being there.
His friends told me, you know, he had this tough cop facade, but he was a real softy inside.
He's a sheep in wolf's clothing. He's got a smart mouth, but he's dumb where it counts.
My character isn't necessarily picked because he's a great shot or a good fighter or a good technician. My character's sort of here because he's been able to stay alive. He has good instincts and he knows when to take cover.